Okay, so this is Miss Weezer, and I've been asked to make an instructional video on how I groom her. This will be a correctional type of video because she is cut awfully short up here. The other groomer, I don't know anything about her, but this puppy's mama says she doesn't know how to do Bichon, so I'm going to try to help out a little bit. Alright, so now we're doing the nails and this. Her quicks are kind of long, but we should be able to get some length off of here. You ready to dremel them? Hold on. It's okay, it's just me. Good girl, Weezer. Good girl. Yeah, okay, that's actually as short as that can go. That's the click right there sticking out. Weezer, honey. Good girl. Good girl. I'm also going to clean the ears, and I'm not so sure they were plucked out last time. They could just grow fast. I don't know. But ear plucking is part of the groomer's job, whether we like it or not. Hold on. I'm not sure. I know a lot of people up, so for a lot of stuff, I don't know. I'm old fashioned. Put the powder in the air. And I like to use my sanitized tea sets. Doesn't seem very pleasant because we've got to pull this hair out, but it's better for their ears if they can breathe. I know, baby. I'm sorry. That's the ear hair. Let me see. It's okay, Weezer, baby. I know. Take a break. I get it. Let me see, baby. Now with a cotton ball, excuse my accent, I'm silly. Ear cleaner, and we're gonna swab out the ear, just clean it out. It's just gonna be wet and cold, honey. You're okay. I'm just swabbing, I'm not pulling. Good girl, Weezer. Good girl. See, I'll show you what a clean ear should look like. Hold on. Well, excuse my camera, monkey working it. There. That is after plucking and cleaning out with the swab. That is a clean ear. Weezer! I know, she said no! Okay, so I did do a little short bit with the anal glands in there, but I had a voice changer and it made it too squeaky and you couldn't understand me. So we'll just keep going on with the facial scrub. Okay. But yeah, I have already brushed the teeth and done the anal glands. It's just that video, too squeaky. It's okay. All right, leave it there. Shake it off, bud. She has a very curly coat. She has a very thick, very curly coat, so we have to make sure we get her good and clean, a deep, good clean, so we can fluff her properly. This right here is the facial scrub, the blueberry facial scrub, and I like to do a little cross on the nose, going down the nose and across the cheek, and then just work it in and work up that gunk with my fingernails while I scrub in the facial scrub. Most of the dogs kind of feel like this is a massage, so they don't mind it because they're getting pet on their face. to do this to make sure it's clean. The facial scrub is tearless, so you can be pretty good around them eyes and not really worry about it. Now, where is my lavender? Now I'm mixing her up some lavender. And we are going to wash her in lavender shampoo because purple and blue shampoos are good on white dogs, first of all. But besides that, I really like the lavender, and it's a good calming shampoo. So it's kind of it's to make up for me pulling her ear hair a while ago. I do what I can where I can, yeah. I really do. Actually, you need a little bit more water. This thick coat, you need to wet it down again before you add that soap. Trust me. You're okay. Mix your shampoo well. Yes, Mom? New snap. I gotta wet down again. Okay. There, you don't need that. You're a good girl. So what you do, soap up your dog really good. Very good and soapy. Okay, you're gonna have to rinse just as good. Massage into the coat. Make them enjoy the bath. You know? Besides which, that massage is going to work in that soap all the way down to the skin and ensure a good clean bath. Another problem at a lot of groomers is even just getting the dog clean, because they'll have assistants that don't understand exactly how to get deep down into that coat and get that dog clean. It's a struggle teaching people to. But we venture forth. Okay, Weezer, come back over here. All right, so on top of that, I've already done the massage and the shampoo. Once you've done that, between the toes, the butt, everywhere, you get everywhere on that dog. Everything, squeaky clean, you're a professional, do it right. Okay, so then you take the water and you rinse. And when you think she's rinsed, rinse her again. And then one more time, just for good measure. So you want to make sure that you feel underneath the chest, in the armpits, around the head especially. People are afraid to do this. Hold her nose up. And just make sure you don't get water up her nose. That's really the trick to it. You've got to do a good job rinsing. It's very bad for them if you leave soap in their coat. Very bad. They'll be itching forever. Now that I've rinsed her about 50 times, maybe like 3 or 4 for real, but she's got thick hair. What I'm going to do is right now I'm wringing out the excess water just to make it easier to dry. So just pat her down, squeeze the water out what you can, you know, don't pinch her, don't hurt her, but squeeze the water out what you can. That tail. And then, if you're lucky enough to have one, grab your carbon towel because it will dry her so much better and faster. Get a good towel dry on her. And if there's too much water in your towel, wring it out because it does pick it up good. There he is. Heavens to Bessie. So wring that out. So this is important to note. If she's clean, and I bathed her, so I'm pretty sure she is, because I work very hard on that, she will dry faster, she will fluff better, and she will feel softer. Like, she will be an overall, the bathing is your foundation for a good groom. If you don't bathe right, honey, you won't groom right. So, this is some Vitalizing Mist. It's a good coat conditioner finishing spray. I do this before I dry them, after I towel dry them. Cover your eyes. There you go. Now, I'm pretty sure Weezer here is comfortable with force drying, the high velocity dryer, which is the best way to get your I shouldn't say the best way, but it's the fastest way to get your curls fluffed out. But there's other ways that usually take longer. But if your dog is nervous about high velocity drying, start on low and start on the back end. Excuse the mess. Is this a bathing / storage room? You see, but she's fine with it, so you see you go up on this. Like their head done with this dryer, as you can tell. Even if you turn it down, she's like, to be honest, I don't remember how she is on the stand dryer either. We're about to find out. This nifty little thing is like a convertible dryer. Fan of this either, but it's a lot more gentle than the force dryer. Okay. Come here. And I need this head straight. So this is one of those times where you gotta kind of argue with the dog a little bit. But be as gentle as you can. Good girl, Weaver. If you brush up while you're using this, that's the perfect fluff. That's the one that takes longer, but in my opinion, it honestly does a better job. Neither one of them do a good job if you don't get the dog completely dry, though. It's like completely clean, you gotta get them completely dry. So, it's work. It is some work up on her. It's okay, Weaver. Let me get your neck, baby. Alright, so once you get to the point to where you finally have the head dry, look, so fluffy. I would suggest, if you've got the time, which actually kind of makes it faster to do the brushing if you do this, so go ahead and use the stand dryer on the whole body while you brush up. That'll give you the perfect fluff everywhere. All over the body. It'll help you brush it out. It'll give you the perfect fluff. She'll be gorgeous, but she goes. And that's what you want. You want gouges. Brush out your tail, you know? Brush it. Brush it. Okay, so this is a common thing, and y'all might be a little snow blind right now. That's a thing, too, with white dogs. But this right here is longer.
And the rest of the hair. Let's see if I can, in that location. Is there a good shot of that? There we go. There it is. There's a good shot of that. Okay. That's armpit hair. And it's like that on both. This is easy for a groomer to miss. Those hairs tuck themselves up in those armpits and hide from us. Okay, so just be aware of that. And whenever you're finishing your groom, go back and make sure that you got rid of those tags. We will do that at the end of this groom as well. After all, this is just before the groom, after the bath. So dry, so clean, and definitely a good foundation. All right, now that we're on the grooming table, I have this fancy dancy 5-in-1 blade that I put on the shortest setting, which is like a 40, and I do the pads. Takes me a minute. I do a good job. I get all the nooks and crannies between the toes and all that jazz. Just the pads. You're not shaving the feet. This is not a pool. Just saying. Just because it's curly doesn't mean it's a pool. There are some baby groomers that need to hear that. And then you switch to a 10. Your stomach. That tail, don't cut the tail up. You do want to get around the privates though. The hips keep them cleaner so they don't get all matted up like they are right now. It's okay, Weezer. Got you, baby girl. It's all up in that tummy. Good girl, good girl. Just the whole pocket over there. And over there. Huh? Okay, do that 10 also underneath the rear. Hold on, Weezer. So she doesn't pick herself. That gets it much neater. And what I have that I've done on Weezer before, she has two groomers. She has me whenever she's visiting in this area. She doesn't live in this area, and she's got her regular groomer back where she lives. So I do a one guard Bichon clip. This makes scissoring a little bit easier. You don't have to do all the scissoring. You could take a guard on the bottom. And if your dog is clean, your guard will run through it. Unless it does that. There's always a snag. Let's see. Come on, Weezer, stand up. There you go. I notice I'm just doing the body with this one. The legs should be a little bit fuller on a Bichon, especially down there towards the bottom, I think. Base of the skull right here, start with that, and then go down the body. Come on, Lisa. As we continue, you can see right here, okay. Right behind the ear. One, there's a knot there, so it's not down here.
I'll work around. Just get that body down the size. And we'll fix those legs up here in a minute. As we continue, you can see. Right here? Okay. There we go. I have this right here from like right behind the ear. One. There's a knot there, so it's not down here. I'll work around. Just get that body down the size. And we'll fix those legs up here in a minute. Inches under the eyes. Good girl, Weezer. I know. Totally change the shape of that. But we will work with it. I'm making a video, Mom. Okay, so mind you, someone else worked on this head. This is not how I would do it. But what I would normally do is come forward. You can see this is all very, I'm not sure how well you can see it. It's all very jagged and chopped shorter on top than it is on the bottom. Get some short straights and scissor right over the eyes. Make that even right there. Just trim the bangs of the Bichon, like this right here. Back to the little eye corners right here. And fluff it up. Here, thank you for that. This way there. You want like a rounded, you want it to blend in with the ears. Do not make a distinguishing mark between the ear and the top knot. Just give it a nice, smooth finish. A nice rounded head on top. You're okay, Lizzie. Are you dancing? Don't be a dancer, Lizzie. Now, speaking of not having the fine marks around the ears and the top knot, you don't really want to be able to see the difference between the ear and the side of the face. That should blend all together. So that needs to grow out on this dog. This should not be rounded like a teddy bear face. underneath the ear like that. Now there is a style that looks like a big round ball for the head, but that's not the style that I do. I do the more old-fashioned style of a bell myself. This head is not going to be perfect because the person that did her before was not experienced in Bichons. And this is kind of a correction, but growing out will have to happen. Now with the bell head, you do want like a flat bottom. Look over here, Reezer. Okay, so probably not the perfect angle on that camera.
Bring your booty over here so we can see what we're doing better.
Okay, so just kind of support the neck and go straight across with these shears. And that'll be creating the bottom of your face. I am going to even out the cheeks a little bit where I normally wouldn't trim, but otherwise it's not going to look good. So I'll take this and make it even with the rest of the face. Just and scissor that a little. Now, my love, let me see. I'm going to scissor the legs. I scissor the legs because it makes them look fuller, and to me it's more true to the Bichon look. With the fuller legs. Hold on, babe. Do straights with these. Now this right here, where it curves in like that, that's a bad image for it. Where it curves in over the foot, I believe it should go straight for a Bichon. The hair should just be long enough to go straight down, straight to the foot from this part of the leg. So all that right there should be hair, and it's not. So I'm just gonna tidy it up. See, this right here is what I was talking about. This right here should be straight up and down. Should go straight from this part of the leg straight down to the foot. You should not have that bend in that leg. But since we do, we're going to make it look even so she looks freshly groomed. Make sure you get the inside of these legs. Here, run away again. Now the front legs should be just like the back legs. There's not supposed to be this bend right here. It's supposed to be straight up and down, just one big fluff column. So it needs to grow out right here in front of the feet. Or on top of the feet, I guess. That area. Take your straight and mate these front legs straight. Fur pillars. What do you mean? Did you hear something come out of my mouth? I said fur pillars. Shows what you know. It's an instruction video, Mom. Why would I say a bad word? Monkey working the camera, though. I'm not even pointing at what I'm doing. Okay, so our groom is pretty much done. Make sure you look for that infamous armpit hair and cut it before you send that dog home. It'll trick you. And wait for it, brush the tail. I don't trim the tail on a Bichon unless they ask me to. sassy, you're rude. Make sure you know where that tail is and you don't get that mat splitter. Like, you don't get it in the mat splitter, because that would not be good.